गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यू चैप्टर इंट्रोडक्शन टू थ्री डायमेंशनल ज्योमेट्री। स्टैंडर्ड 10th में कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री था, सेम उसके रिलेटेड ये चैप्टर है। उसमें भी डिस्टेंस फॉर्मूला थी, सेम यहाँ भी डिस्टेंस फॉर्मूला है, बट उसमें क्या था कि टू एक्सिस थी, एक्स एंड वाई एक्सिस, सो टू कोऑर्डिनेट थे। नाउ हियर थ्री एक्सिस इज प्रेजेंट बिकॉज नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज थ्री डायमेंशनल ज्योमेट्री, दैट मीन्स थ्री एक्सिस प्रेजेंट हियर, एक्स एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस एंड जेड एक्सिस। तो यहाँ फॉर्मूला सेम रहेंगी, कोऑर्डिनेट थ्री कोऑर्डिनेट आएंगे। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डिस्कस, टुडे अवर टॉपिक इज डिस्टेंस फॉर्मूला। सो here a coordinate is present, suppose x1 y1 and z1, and b into bracket x2 y2 comma z2. now here two coordinate is present. Now find out the distance between both these coordinate. So ab is equal to under root distance of the x coordinate, that means x2 minus x1 whole square. यहाँ हम x1 minus x2 भी लिख सकते हैं, because here whole square form is present, so answer में कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा इसमें। y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. So simple topic है, a and b coordinate is present, and find out the distance between both these point. So how can we find out? So at that time here using by distance formula, ab is equal to under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. Now उसके related थोड़े example discuss करेंगे। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, ए कोऑर्डिनेट 2, 3, 5 एंड बी कोऑर्डिनेट 4, 3, 1। नाउ अवर क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड आउट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन बोथ दिस पॉइंट। सो ए कोऑर्डिनेट, हियर वी कैन कंसिडर x1, y1, z1 एंड बी कोऑर्डिनेट रिटर्न हियर x2, y2, z2। नाउ आफ्टर फाइंड आउट द डिस्टेंस ऑफ बोथ दिस पॉइंट, सो ए बी इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट x2 माइनस x1, दैट मीन्स 4 माइनस 2 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 3 माइनस 3 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 1 माइनस 5 होल स्क्वायर, सो इज इक्वल टू अंडर 4 माइनस 2 होल स्क्वायर, दैट मीन्स 2 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 0 होल स्क्वायर प्लस 1 माइनस 5, दैट मीन्स माइनस 4 होल स्क्वायर, सो इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट 2 स्क्वायर, दैट मीन्स 4 प्लस 0 प्लस माइनस 4 स्क्वायर, दैट मीन्स 16 प्लस 4 अंडर रूट 20। सो आवर आंसर इज ए बी इज इक्वल टू, हियर वी गेट अंडर रूट 20। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, सेकंड माइनस 3, 7, 2 एंड 2, 4, -1। नाउ अगेन हियर टू पॉइंट इज प्रेजेंट, अवर क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड आउट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन बोथ दिस पॉइंट। सो फर्स्ट हियर वी कैन कंसिडर ए कोऑर्डिनेट -3, 7, 2। नाउ दिस कोऑर्डिनेट से x1, y1, z1 एंड another point B into bracket 2 comma 4 comma minus 1. So is equal to written here x2 comma y2 comma z2. Now after find out the distance between both these points. So again same formula using here distance of x coordinate, y coordinate and z coordinate. So here x2 minus x1, 2 minus minus plus 3 whole square plus 4 minus 7 whole square plus minus 1 minus 2 whole square. Now simplify this term. So is equal to under root 3 plus 2, 5 whole square, that means 25, plus 4 minus 7, that means minus 3, minus 3 whole square, that means 9, plus minus 1, minus 2, again minus 3, and minus 3 whole square, that means 9. So 25, 9 plus 9, that means 18. So is equal to simplify this term. So here we get answer 43. Okay. Next question. Question number 3. Here two point is present. So again same method apply here. First of all, here we can consider A coordinate 2 comma minus 1 comma 3. Now this coordinate say x1 comma y1 comma z1 and B coordinate minus 2 1 comma 3. So here we can write x2 comma y2 comma z2. Now again find out the distance between both these points. So AB is equal to under root y, x2 minus x1, that means minus 2 whole square plus 1 minus minus plus 1 whole square plus 3 minus 3 whole square. Now simplify this term. So is equal to under root minus 2 minus 2, that means minus 4 whole square means 16, 1 plus 1 means 2, 2 square 4, and 3 minus 3, that means 0. Now 16 plus 4, that means under root 20. So our answer is under root 20. Next question, question number 4. Our question is, so that the points minus 2, comma 3, comma 5, 1, comma 2, comma 3 and 7, comma 0, comma minus 1 are polynomial. So first of all, what is the meaning of polynomial? So collinear, that means we know that all these three points are lying on the same line. But here how can we prove that using by distance formula, how can we prove that they are collinear? So first of all, first coordinate we can consider A, second coordinate consider B, third coordinate consider C. Now after find out distance of AB, BC and AC and two distance, so we get third distance, so we can say that this condition are collinear. So first here we can consider here A coordinate minus 2 comma 3 comma 5, B coordinate 1, 2, 3 and C coordinate 7, 0, -1. Now after find out AB. So AB is equal to under root 1 -2 whole square plus 2 -3 whole square plus 3 -5 whole square. So is equal to under root 2 + 1 = 3. 3 square that means 9 + 1 + 4. That means here written 9 + 1 = 10. 10 + 4 that means 14. Now after find out BC. So BC is equal to distance of B and C. Means 7 - 1 whole square plus 0 - 2 whole square plus -1 - 3 whole square. So is equal to, now here simplify this term. So 7 - 1 that means 6 and 6 whole square that means 36 plus 4 plus -4 whole square that means 16. Now add this number. So 36 + 4 that means 40. 40 + 16 that means 56. Now 14 = 56. So here written this way under root 4 into 14 and square root of 4 2. So 2 under root 14. So here we get BC is equal to 2 under root 40. Now after find out CA. So CA is equal to same process apply here. -2 - 7 whole square plus 3 - 0 whole square plus 5 - -1 whole square. Again simplify this term. So is equal to under root -9 whole square. That means 81 + 9 + 36. Okay. Now add this number. So 81 + 9 that means 90. 90 + 36 that means 126. And 126 that means here we can return under root 9 into 14. Square root of 9 that means 3. So here written 3 under root 14. Now which true term add? So we get third term. So here we can add AB plus BC. So here we get CA. So therefore here we can write AB plus BC is equal to CA. So therefore we can say that A, B and C are collinear. Clear? Question number 5. Verify here 3 coordinate is present 0, 7, -10, 1, 6, -6 and 4, 9, -6 are the vertices of an isosceles triangle. Now, first of all, what is the meaning of isosceles triangle? Isosceles, that means we know that any two sides we get same, so we can say that this triangle is called isosceles triangle. So now here 3 coordinate is present. Using by this 3 coordinate, first of all find out 3 side. Now which 2 side and simplify this term. So we get 2 side equal. So say that this triangle is isosceles triangle. So first of all here we can consider let A coordinate 0, -7, -10. बी कोऑर्डिनेट 1, 6, -6 एंड सी कोऑर्डिनेट 4, 9, -6. नाउ आफ्टर फाइंड आउट ए बी, सो ए बी इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट 1 -0² प्लस 6 -7 होल स्क्वायर प्लस -6 -10 होल स्क्वायर, सो इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट 1 -0 दैट मीन्स 1 एंड 1 स्क्वायर मीन्स 1, 6 -7 मीन्स -1, -1² अगेन 1 प्लस 10 -6 दैट मीन्स 4, 4 स्क्वायर मीन्स 16. So now add these numbers, so here we get under root 18. Now after find out BC and CA, so BC is equal to 4 under root 4 minus 1 whole square plus 9 - 6 whole square प्लस -6 + 6 होल स्क्वायर. नाउ एड सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस नंबर, सो इज इक्वल टू 4 - 3 - 3 4 - 1 दैट मीन्स 3, 3 स्क्वायर मीन्स 9, 9 - 6 अगेन 3, 3 स्क्वायर मीन्स 9 एंड हियर 0, सो अगेन हियर वी गेट 18, अंडर रूट 18. नाउ आफ्टर फाइंड आउट सी ए, already AB and BC both this side we get same answer, but after also we can find out CA. So CA is equal to 0 - 4 whole square plus 7 - 9 whole square and -10 + 6 whole square. So under root 4 - 4 whole square means 16 plus 7 - 9 that means -2 whole square 4 and -10 + 6 that means -4 square that means 16. So here we get under root 36. Okay. Now our question is verify the condition is isosceles triangle. So here we get any two sides are equal, and here AB and BC both sides here we get equal. So therefore, now here we can written, therefore AB is equal to BC. So hence triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Clear? Now, next question. What is the meaning of right angle triangle? So, our question number 6. Here verify the condition of first of all here coordinate is given 0, 7, 10 -1, -6, 6 and -4, 9, 6 are the vertices of an right angle triangle. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of right angle triangle? Right angle triangle, that means we know that here using by the result of Pythagoras theorem, but first we can find out AB square after find out BC square and after find out CA square. Now sum of any two term we get same to third term. So we can say that he has satisfied the this condition, and we can say that this triangle is a right angle triangle. So again here we can consider that A coordinate 0, 7, 10, B coordinate -1, 6, 6, and C coordinate -4, 9, 6. Now after find out AB square. So AB square, that means -1. Now here whole square form is present. So here we can not written under root because squaring form is present. So remove this under root. So here how can be written? So -1, -0 whole square plus 6, -7 whole square plus 6, -10 whole square. -1 square, that means 1. 6, -7, -1 whole square 1. 6, -10, -4. -4 whole square, that means 16. So here we get AB square is equal to 18. Now after find out BC square. So again whole square form is present, so remove this under root sign. So BC square, that means -4 + 1 whole square. Right here -4, -1, +1. Because in between minus sign is present, so here it is +1. Now 9 - 6 whole square plus 6 - 6 whole square. Now simplify this term. So is equal to -4 + 1 - 3 whole square 9. 9 - 6, that means 3 square and 9 plus 0, that means again 18. So here we get BC square is equal to 18, and find out CA square. CA square, that means -4 - 0 whole square plus, okay, here we can return A minus C or C minus A also. Now 9 - 7 also whole square plus 6 - 10 whole square. So is equal to -4 whole square, that means 16, plus 9 - 7, that means 2 whole square 4, and here 6 - 10, that means -4 whole square 16. Add these numbers, so we get 36. So here we get CA square is equal to 36. Now AB square plus BC square is equal to, here we get CA square. So therefore here written this condition. So therefore AB square plus BC square is equal to CA square. So therefore here we can say that angle B is right angle. Here AB square plus BC square, so common angle is B, so that's why here we can say that angle B is right angle triangle. Clear?